Yo, welcome back for another ep of Becoming Dope, which is all about my journey as a photographer into the world of filmmaking. My name is Tayo, and today we're gonna talk about how to fix color shifts in video caused by auto white balance on your camera, and why for video, you should always try to avoid using auto white balance. So if you're coming from the world of photography like me, unless you're doing a major commercial shoot where you have complete control over your lighting and you're getting paid thousands of dollars to make sure color and exposure are perfect for print, you may not be thinking about adjusting white balance in your camera. Why not? Well, if you shoot in raw format for photos like I do, you give yourself maximum flexibility in post to adjust your white balance for a single image or a single frame, if need be. But in the world of video, you're now dealing with shooting minimally 24 frames or 24 images per second. Imagine manually adjusting white balance for 24 images for every second of video. Nah, son. Now in my first video, I believe I understand why my color temperature shifted so drastically, and that's because I use mixed temperature lighting. I really like the way it looks on the wall. My background light from above is super warm, the LED light from below is super blue, and both my key light on my right and my kicker here behind me on my left are different mixes of warm and cool. So I think the camera sensor was just really confused and it just kept trying to adjust white balance for my mixed lighting scene. Now, if you're dealing with lighting sources that all have the same color temperature, or you're running and gunning, say from indoors to outdoors with no time to adjust, then auto white balance may serve you well. But as a DP, if I wanna maximize my creativity and lighting options for a scene, then this sort of continuous and dynamic white balancing is just not an option. Now that said, if you do leave on auto white balance and you experience major color and temperature shifts in your footage, I'm gonna show you how to fix it in three steps. Step number one. Turn off auto white balance. Before you record anything else, I want you to walk over to your camera and turn off auto white balance for video. Be sure to select the white balance option for your video settings and not your photography settings. They are usually separate. It's usually pretty easy to find under your camera's menus, and once you find it, you'll want to select a white balance preset that most closely resembles the main lighting that you have in your scene. For me and my YouTube videos, I find that a daylight fluorescent setting as seen on the camera live view most closely resembles what I see with my naked eye. Now, I'm not gonna talk too much more about setting up white balance as I'm planning to do another video which explains how to use a color checker like this for perfect exposure and color, so stay tuned for that. Step number two, try color stabilizer in After Effects. I really wanted this one to work for me and the effect was trying hard to, but I think the color shifts I had were just too drastic. Overall, it seems to be a better tool for balancing exposure than color temperature shifts. It's fairly easy to use. Once you import your clip into After Effects, you'll have the option of setting a white point, black point, and midpoint in a reference frame of the clip, and the stabilizer will attempt to use those sampled points to stabilize exposure and color in every other frame within the clip. I'm not gonna go into too much more detail on this one, but give it a try and see if it works in your situation. Step number three. Automate your white balance correction with keyframes in Adobe Premiere. Now, I found this method to produce the best overall results from my situation. It was a bit more work, but I was happier with the final product in the end. Let's open up Premiere and take a look. So in Premiere, the first thing we wanna do is take our problem clip and drop it into our timeline here. And we can immediately start to scrub this to see what some of the problem areas are and the challenges. You can see in the beginning of this clip, it's very warm. And as you move towards the center of the clip, it starts to cool off. And then you can see that the auto white balance is really, really working hard in camera, and it started to really warm things up. So this is obviously not usable the way it is, and we want to make sure we can balance the color temperature. So we'll spend some time doing that. The first thing we're gonna do actually is duplicate this clip. So we're gonna hit Alt, left mouse key button here, and then drop this on the same track here. And the reason why we're doing this is because the first clip will be a reference and the second clip will be what we actually make our adjustments to. You want to make sure in the color layout and then come over to the Lumetri color panel, come down to color wheels and match, select that. You want to make sure that you're in CC 2018 or later for Adobe Premiere, because that is where this comparison view came in as an additional feature. So you select comparison view and you'll see two different windows pop up. One is a reference window and one is current. Please also note that you can select this icon below the timeline here in the program monitor if you want to also toggle that feature as well. So if we take a look at the reference window, you're gonna see this slider at the bottom here. This is actually mimicking what's in the timeline. So as you see, as I come across here, I'm actually traversing the first clip, and then you'll see shortly there I am in the second clip. So what we wanna make sure is for the reference frame that we select, we wanna make sure that you're within the first clip, because we don't wanna see changes happening to our reference frame. And I'm gonna go ahead and select something that looks desirable in terms of overall color temperature. That looks about right to me. I like the way that looks. And we're basically gonna try to match the secondary clip here to have this same sort of color temperature. Once you've done that, the next thing you wanna do is add an adjustment layer. I typically like to add an adjustment layer. You can also make your changes directly on top of the clip itself. But my workflow generally is with an adjustment layer. In this instance, it really honestly doesn't matter because these changes will be very unique to this clip itself. But for workflow purposes, I'll go ahead and use an adjustment layer. Now, once we've added the adjustment layer, you want to come back up to your Lumetri color panel here. We can close out color wheels and mask and just open up the basic correction. Now, under basic correction, you see you have white balance settings here, temperature and tint. These are the two things that we're primarily focused on when it comes to white balance. I'm really going to focus just on automating changes with keyframes with the temperature, but you can also do that with tint if desired, if you want to try to dial things in a bit better. Now, the best way to apply the Lumetri color effect is to simply hit the reset button. But first, make sure you have your adjustment layer selected here, and then come over here and hit reset. And you'll see that Lumetri color is now applied as an effect to this adjustment layer over under here under effects controls. Now, another way to do that is to select effects here itself. You can come over to video effects. You can scroll down to color correction and then take the Lumetri color effect and drop it on top of the adjustment layer. But as you can see, the hitting the reset button is much faster. We're then gonna come over to our effects control tab. Over here is where we're gonna do all of our automation. We're gonna add keyframes and make color temperature adjustments as needed. So again, you wanna make sure you have your adjustment layer selected, and then we're going to come to the top of that here. Let's get to the top of that clip here. And I wanna move in just till I have my first full frame here. And I'm gonna come over here to temperature. I'm gonna open that up, and you're gonna see a slider here for temperature. I'm gonna actually add a keyframe right there at that point. So we can go ahead and slide this to the left here and try to cool this off a bit. We have our reference frame up. We're trying to match that as closely as possible. And you can see, if I go too hard left, it's gonna be too cool. If I go too hard right, it's obviously ridiculously warm. So we wanna basically kind of find that sweet spot here. And that's looking pretty good. I can already see there's some tint issues here, but from a color temperature standpoint, this is pretty much where I want it to be. Let me warm it up just a little bit more here. Okay, the issue now is that once we start to play this clip, we're gonna see that, especially when we get to the reference point itself, that this clip is really gonna cool off here. I'm just about right there is where, let's see here, boom, I think it's right there. That's the exact location of our reference frame. And you can see that this got very, very cool. So what we wanna do is add another keyframe at this location. And you can actually use this little button right here to add an additional keyframe. And we're gonna bring our color temperature back over to essentially zero where it was before we started, because it's going to match the color temperature of the reference frame. You can already see that we're starting to see an improvement here. When I let this play out, it's fairly consistent. I definitely see where there's some other areas here where I can make some adjustments, and we'll come back to that. We know that towards the end of the frame, it gets very, very, very warm. So we're gonna do a similar adjustment over here. So I'm gonna take this to the end of the clip and come back just a couple of frames here. And we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna add another keyframe, and we're going to now cool this off. We're gonna bring this down and get this again right to about where it looks the same as our reference frame. And that's looking pretty decent there, not too bad. So let's take a look at the entire clip playing here. If I hit play on here, the major shifts are gone. which is what we're looking for, but I definitely see some fine-tuned adjustments that can be made here. For instance, right here at this point, it seems to be a little bit warmer than I want it to be. It's almost like it took too long to get cool at the end here. So I wanna come back here to this particular portion of the clip, and I can actually add yet another keyframe, and I can cool this off. So it's gonna actually have two different ramps. It's gonna cool to this point a little bit faster, and then it's going to slow it down when it gets to the last keyframe there. So I think we want to pull this right about here. I think that looks pretty decent. It's not too bad. I definitely see some green cast on here where we could do some automation of the tint, but again, we'll just stay focused on color temperature. And let's see how that feels. Just drag this back right to the center of the clip here, hit play on that, and see how it looks. You can kind of see now that things are looking a bit more consistent towards the end of that clip here. Now, I also noticed a problem spot at the beginning of this clip too, where right here, it seems to be super warm before it starts cooling off again. And at the very beginning, it was cool enough, but for some reason it dipped back down here in terms of warmth. So I wanna actually add another keyframe at this location here. Let's go ahead and do that. And I wanna cool this off as well. I'm gonna bring this down here and get this to look more like my reference frame here. Right about there, I think. So let's take a look at this entire clip and see how it plays. And as you can see, the color temperature, at least to the naked eye, looks much more consistent. It's much less of a distraction. And that's exactly what we wanted to do. Let's go ahead and take another look at that clip. I'm gonna take the Lumetri color effect off. And there it is, very warm, back to cool, and back to super warm again. You know, if I pause it right there and I toggle the effect here, you can definitely see how the color temperature is being manipulated here in the best interest of color temperature. And that's how you can fix color temperature shifts caused by auto white balance in Adobe Premiere. Well, that's all for now. I hope this was helpful. If you have other tips and tricks when it comes to fixing color temperature shifts in your video, please feel free to share in the comments below. Please like this video if it was helpful. And for more creative and technical tidbits on my Becoming Dope journey, please be sure to subscribe. Thank you again, everyone. And until next time, stay dope.